guys, so this is look number two using the Lila palette. This time around I have used more of the copper gold tones. Oh god, I'm like putting my nails into these, like, so I ended up using these colors right here, and these are my matte shades, and I generally went over here, and as part of my highlight under my brow bone I used this guy. So I basically used pretty much everything in the palette except this one and this one. I think these two I didn't use, but everything else I kind of used, which is great because these two can go together, to be honest. This on your crease and then this on your lid, it gives a very editorial look. But yeah, that's two looks with this palette. I highly, highly recommend this palette if you like pinks and purples, but like you can see, you can always do a warm bronzy look with this palette too. You do not need to wing it out as much as I did. You do not need to go dramatic. I did not put out any false lashes because I guess this is more of a socially acceptable look, though it sounds so weird. Like just a wearable look on a day-to-day basis, maybe for work. Again, if you don't do the wing eyeliner and just leave it with mascara, you'll be fine. But these are how the shades blend, and they blend very beautifully. If my inner tear duct is looking cray cray, it's just because I have allergies and my eyes are watering. My eyes are watering quite a bit. So my base is the same from the first makeup tutorial, part one. I just ended up putting a more peachy orangey blush with a more of a golden to match the eyeshadow highlight, and a nude lip, and of course I changed my earring. That's about it. Everything else is the same. So if you would like to see how I did this makeup look, keep on watching. Just a side note, towards the end I will have swatches on my hands so you can see how they look on my skin tone. Now, one thing I did not say in that video is that that is just glamorous out there makeup. You do not need to do as much as I did. You can always tone it down, keep it in your crease, keep it near your eyelid. You don't need to blow it out as much as I did. So you can always make it wearable with those color combinations, if that makes sense. So, that one was mainly focusing on the purples, and now I'm going to be focusing more on the copper shades in the palette, which is on this side. I have them swatched, so if you don't have this palette, for some comparisons, this is how it looks like. I'm looking into this in my outer. This has a highlight, maybe this to deepen. These shades are, from the top, we have Cyclone, Magnolia, and Dragon Bite. Dragon Bite is a duochrome color, which looks like it's brown, looks like Blue Brown by MAC. And weirdly enough, the star palette in Natasha Denona, this one right here, do you see how it has a duo? And this is called Orion. But Orion, it has more of a, let's watch it, brown reflex. Can you see that? And in the Lila palette, Dragon Bite is more of a purple shade. Can you see? So they look very similar, but they're too different when you swatch them. So I'm gonna be using this maybe like half of my eye. Use that more in the center. Use that as a topper. Magnolia, is that the color? Yeah, Magnolia, the gold shade, is not meant to be used on its own. if I'm not mistaken. If I'm wrong, I'm so sorry. But I think this is mainly used as a topper, and she recommends to use this either most likely with your fingers, because the warmth of your finger will melt the pigment. Again, this is why I love these shadows. And this, taking your big fluffy brush, I'm going to go in with the top color right here, which is meant to be nude vino or vino. That's it right there. And the swatch is that one right there. I'm gonna take that. Again, this is gonna be a transition. Put it right about my socket. This one, we are not going to blow it out, so try to keep it tight, small circular motions like so. You can see how quickly that blended. All right, now I'm going to take Amara, which is the second deep matte shade, so I'm working with those two. Smaller brush going in with Amara, just gonna control that right in the crease. Do that. And again, I have a bump here, so my techniques to hide this are a little more different than the average person, so I would say always look at what I'm doing on this eye than this one, unless you have a bump too. And welcome to the bump family. Okay, while we are here, we're gonna add a shimmer to our eyes, which is Junia, which is the bottom shimmer shade right there. I'm gonna take a tad, pop it right under my brow. I'm going to use my flat one. I am going to spritz it. You don't have to with these shadows. I am. And I'm going to put it on my outer corner. Actually, you know what? No, I'm going to put it all over my lid. And I'm gonna take the same brush and I'm gonna go in with Dragon Bite and flip my brush over, use the other side, and I'm gonna pat it right in the corner. You know what? I'm gonna use my fingers. Okay. I'm like literally dusting it on the outer corner. Good. Again, if I start seeing harsh lines, which I am, I'm going to take my brush, just blend it away. Fingers. I'm going to go into Magnolia, the one that I was telling you, this beautiful bronzy shade. I'm not flipping you off, I'm just going to use this and like put it in the inner corner. I am just doing, you can just leave it where I left it. Pop on some eyeliner and call it a day. Quickly dust any fallout. Actually, a fluffier blending brush. Go in with Cyclone, the bronze shade. Pop it right on the outer. Connected to the shadow on top. And on the inner corner, I'm going to be using Magnolia, that gold one, and I'm bringing it all the way in. Like on my skin, it will look like a inner corner highlight, but if you're lighter than me, it may not. And in such case, use whatever shadow you use on your brow bone, use that as a. I'm gonna take Amara the darker of the brown shade mixed with the second nude, the two matte shades. I'm gonna take those shades and I'm just gonna put it right outside the blends in. And then I am going to line my eyes with a liquid liner. Anyone would do. And I will be right back. So this is how the look is looking. I reapplied mascara, I winged out my liner. You do not need to wing it out as much as I do. You can keep it short. I even lined my waterline with black Kohl pencil, anyone you got. If you see my eyes smudging a little bit in the tear duct area, especially here, I guess I have allergies and my eyes are watering quite a bit, so that's why that's happening. I went ahead and put a peach, like an orangey peach blush with a more of a gold highlighter. And my lips are currently nude because it depends really with this nude look, like copper toned. You basically can wear any kind of lip that you would want to wear. You could wear a nice vampy lip and go with that, or go for a nude. Something like that. That is too toned down, so I'm gonna use a darker lip liner just to deepen it up. So this is what the finished look looks like. I paired it with just a nude lip because, again, we're going for a natural, more friendly, daytime wearable look. This is using the same Lila palette, but I ended up using the cool tones. So just goes to show you how versatile this palette is. And of course, you can do as basic as just throwing a wash of color all over your lids, putting your bronzer into your crease, you're good to go. Hope you liked it. If you did, give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe or hit that bell button if you would like to know when I upload my next videos. I think that's about it. I'll talk to you all soon. Stay beautiful, everyone.